Hey guys, we are back in the lab again for another silicone casting experiment. You might remember in a previous video, I tried casting some of these pokeballs with silicone, and the problem we ended up having was bubbles that got trapped in the rubber, which transferred to all the successive castings. So in this video, we're gonna try recasting these pokeballs and seeing if we can get rubber molds that are completely bubble free. So in a follow-up video, we made this thing. This is a vacuum chamber that's designed to suck the air out of the silicone before we pour it. So in this video, we're gonna put it all to the test. We've got our vacuum chamber, we've got our pokeballs, and we've got some more silicone. So let's get busy making some more rubber molds. Now, I showed you in a previous experiment that you could use glass cookie jars as your vacuum chamber, but for this experiment, I'm going back to my pressure pot because it's wide enough to accept this popcorn dish that I found at the dollar store. This is only about a buck and it fits perfectly inside the container here. You can see the lid fits on and everything's flush. And because it's paper, it's disposable, which means very easy cleanup. All right, update guys, we got our pokeballs set and positioned, and I took a little bit of a different approach this time. Let me show you what I did. First of all, I took the pokeballs and set them upright so the button is facing toward the ceiling. This way, if there are any accidental air bubbles trapped inside, they should be able to follow the lines and escape. Second of all, I took some clay and made a big base around the bottoms, and this is to help form a reservoir, so when we're pouring molten gummy, wax, or molten aluminum, it'll have a reservoir to draw from as it cools and keep the pokeballs full. Hopefully with those improvements, we can make ourselves some perfect silicone molds. So now we can mix up a new batch of silicone and use our vacuum chamber to suck the air bubbles out, and then as we pour it, we want to pour it in a long, thin stream far away from the pokeball itself. As the liquid level rises, it should push any trapped air out and give us a perfect silicone casting. Oh, it's so satisfying. We've got our silicone and our catalyst blended, but it's full of air bubbles. So now we're gonna transfer it to this popcorn container, stick it inside our vacuum chamber, and suck those air bubbles out. Now we actually only wanna fill this up about a third of the way, from what I understand, because the air bubbles are going to go crazy. And unfortunately, that's more than a third of the way. So we're gonna have to be very careful. Let's go ahead and extract these bubbles. Now I can actually regulate the airflow here. You can see it's digging deep down in the silicone now and pulling out all those bubbles. It's not giving them a chance to pop. Whoops, uh-oh. Made a mess. Okay, so a lesson that we just learned, when you're putting silicone in the vacuum chamber, you only want to use about 1/3 of the liquid because the bubbles will rise up and contaminate everything. If there's not enough space for the bubbles to come up and start popping, they're gonna hit the lid, and every time you deflate it, it's just gonna repeat the process. So you need to leave enough of a gap so that the bubbles come up and have a chance to escape. Ooh, that was close, that was close. And that right there, my friends, is the magic. Well, that's kind of cool. If I move it around, I can actually like access different parts of the silicone and get that bubbling faster. Oh wow, that looks amazing. It's very cool, the way that that churns. You can see it's digging deep down in the silicone now and pulling out all those bubbles. The longer we let this sit, the more air is gonna come out, and ideally it would get to the point where there are no more bubbles whatsoever. But I'm a little bit nervous on timing because I wanna get this silicone poured before it actually sets up. So we might just take it out now and pour it. There we go. It looks like it's ready. We've sucked out quite a few of the air bubbles here now. I'm excited to see what difference this makes. Now, as we pour this, the key is to pour a long, thin strand next to the pokeball, but as far away from it as we can get. We don't actually want it going on the pokeball itself. And you can see that I've painted a thin layer of silicone into some of the problem areas so that as the bubbles rise, they don't get trapped up there. Slow and steady wins the race. That might even be too much. Slow down, Grant. Oh, dang, I'm messy.
That's looking beautiful. Oh my gosh, that is looking beautiful.
So cool guys, our molds are filled up to the top and these are actually looking better than I've ever seen before. In fact, if you look at the surface of these molds, it almost looks like a crystal clear lake reflecting everything perfectly, which is a really good sign. It means we probably don't have any bubbles in there. Now there are a couple lessons I learned while doing this experiment today. Number one, I wouldn't have mixed up the whole batch of silicone at once. Working with so much silicone is very difficult and we're fighting the clock because this stuff sets up in about 30 minutes. So if you try this yourself, divide your silicone into different batches and mix one at a time. Number two, when you're mixing this, it's been suggested to mix it by hand because you'll introduce less air by doing that. By using something like these mixing beaters that I was using, it's actually pumping a ton of air into there, which means it takes a lot longer in the vacuum chamber to extract all those bubbles back out. So if you have the option, don't use a mixing beater, mix your silicone by hand. So that's it for today, because these things are gonna need about 24 hours to cure, so we're gonna let them sit overnight and we'll take a look at the final result tomorrow. Thanks for joining me for this project. I'll be looking for you in the next video. Talk to you then. Shoot, made a mess. I'll have to clean up later. Hey guys, thanks for watching, and remember, I'm giving away prizes now on every new video. All you have to do to qualify is subscribe to my channel, ring the bell, and select to be notified when my next videos get released. The secret link to my giveaways will be pinned in the comments for the first 12 hours. If you like what I'm doing, show your support right now by giving this video a big thumbs up and share with a friend. I love you back, and I'll see you next time.